they can have a lifestyle like this? Why do they stop all the time?
Well, I think people have a lot of different reasons, but here's the interesting thing. Here's your life right here, and then down here is crisis. So the gap between crisis and where your life is, let's say you lose your job. All of a sudden, you have to find a job. So you go to crisis, and you figure a way to get back here. Or all of a sudden, your car breaks down, and you don't have the money for it. So you figure a way to get the money. But then from here to here is success. And a lot of times, people fail to realize that the gap between this and crisis and this and success is exactly the same. The only difference is consistency. Constantly reminding yourself of your dream. Constantly reminding yourself where you're going so you can continue to push up here. It's easier to drop into crisis. It's a little harder to get into success, but the gap is the same. So you have to have a compounding effect of your dreams. Like Peter, he's here. He used to be on that side in awesome hotels. Now he's on the yacht, but he hasn't arrived. He feels great. He loves this, but he's also looking at the bigger yachts. He's also looking at what else is possible. So we're in a dock here, but we're not staying here the whole time because we haven't arrived. We have to keep moving. And I think that's the difference, Peter, is that sometimes people just fail to constantly compound on the dream. They fail to constantly remind themselves that why they're in the business. They fail to create that hunger that pulls them in the direction of success rather than being comfortable here and then going into crisis, back to comfort, and then thinking about the success. And that's why I love this guy right here, because he's always thinking about, well, how do we become more successful? How do we think bigger? He's always thinking like this, going, I like this yacht, but I wonder what it would take to get on a bigger yacht. And that's really cool. So check it out.